Y como la verdad las cosas.
Hello. Hello guys, good evening everybody. Hello.
Hello teacher.
Okay, let me just... Good evening guys, hope you are okay. How are you, Jorge?
How are you? Good.
Everything, how was your day?
Very tired and busy.
And busy, yeah. Do you have to travel every day?
Yeah, this day my family and compartir.
Share
my family and on me in vacation.
Okay, you are sharing your vacations with your family, spending time with your family. Do they live here in El Salvador or in another country from Central America?
No, in Salvador.
Or in the United States or Canada, you have to travel there, right?
I am happy living in this country, but and here in El Salvador.
Okay, in El Salvador, maybe. Okay, that's great. And is it a big family or a small family?
A small family. Only my mom and my wife.
Okay, and your wife. That's great. There are some people who have a lot of children, right? Like so many. For example, my grandma got like... Nine children, yes. And in that time, I think it's
big family.
Yeah, it was, right? Because nowadays, most of them are already dead. So alive, they are like four or three brothers. Only from nine. Okay, that's why it is becoming even smaller, right?
Okay. And your family is big or small?
Oh, it is very small. I just live with my mother, my father, and my brother, and a big dog. The only big one that we have there is the dog.
Okay, so good.
Yeah, but he's kind of terrible, right? Do you have pets or cats or something like that in your house?
Okay.
Do you have, Jorge?
Yeah.
Do you have dogs?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I little dog and the name is the little dog is Silka.
Silka, okay. Yeah. Why that name?
I don't know. Lo escuché de pega. It's the Siberian Husky.
Oh, that's nice. I guess they must be expensive, right?
Yeah, it's expensive.
Yeah. It's expensive. Okay. Hello, Jennifer. Hello, Eloisa. Okay. Thank you, George, for sharing.
Hello,
hello guys. Good evening. How are
you? Guys.
Hello, Nancy, Eloisa. And let's see who else is joining. Okay, guys. I'm just going to pass the attendance. Remember, this is only for to check that most of you are in the course, right? I'm just going to check the attendance. Hello, Silvana, good to see you. So if I say good evening, don't forget to say present. Okay, Amilcar, is there Amilcar? Amilcar? No? Okay, Angela Alejandra, is there Angela Alejandra? Angela? No? Okay, let's see. Carlos Ademir? No? Okay, Daily Lisette? Daily, are you there, Daily? Eloisa, are you there, Eloisa?
Present.
Okay. Let's see, Hugo Alexander. Is there Hugo? No? Okay, Hugo Ernesto Ayala. Hugo Ernesto Ayala? No? Okay, let's see, Jennifer Noemi. Jennifer Nami? Okay. Okay, Jessica Beverly. Jessica? Okay, let's see. Jorge Elvir Miranda Ramos. Jorge Elvir.
Present.
Okay.
Present.
Okay,
Jorge. Thank you.
Okay, Jorge, why do you have that second name, Elvir? This is the first time I heard that name.
The second name is the my father, the name is, this is Elvis, Elvis.
Oh, instead of Elvis, it is Elvir, to be different, right?
It's a different, okay.
Okay,
that's it's legacy, my father.
It's a legacy. Okay, that's great. To have a legacy. Okay. Yeah. Jose Naum, are you there, Jose Naum? Jose Naum? No? Okay, Mabel? Yes? Jose Naum? No? Okay. Mabel Mendez? Mabel? No? Okay, let's see. Margot Hernandez, are you there, Margot? Margot, no? Okay, Maria Emelina. Maria Emelina, are you there, Maria? Maria Emelina, no? Naum, are you there, Naum? No? Okay, Nancy.
Hello, teacher, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. Who is talking? Yes, who is talking? Can you tell me your name, please?
I'm Naum. Naum Hernandez.
Okay. I got it.
I am.
Okay. Thank you. Nancy Guadalupe. Nancy, are you there, Nancy?
Present.
Okay. Very good. Got it. Oscar Armando Esquivel Quiñones. Are you there, Oscar?
Present.
Okay.
Present.
And Silvana Beatriz. Are you there, Silvana? Silvana?
I'm here, teacher.
Okay. Perfect. Vanessa Odev. Is there Vanessa Odev? Vanessa? No? Let's see. Walter Antonio Santos. Walter, are you there, Walter? No? Okay, let's see. Jairo Vladimir, are you there, Jairo? No? Jairo? No? Okay, let's see. And Linda Vanessa. Linda Vanessa, are you there, Linda? Okay. Great, guys. Let's go over the lesson and let's see what we were studying yesterday. Let's see, Eloisa, tell me what we were studying yesterday. What we study? Yeah, what we were studying yesterday. What we were studying yesterday. ¿Qué estuvimos estudiando ayer? What we were studying yesterday.
Simple present.
Okay, we were studying the simple present.
Affirmative sentence.
Yes, the simple present. We studied the affirmative sentences, right? Affirmative sentences. Okay, what else, Jennifer? What else did we study yesterday?
I don't know, teacher, no, me tuve que desconectar por problemas de señal.
Okay, Jennifer, it's okay, thank you. Nancy, hey, Nancy, what we were studying yesterday, Nancy?
Me tuve que desconectar lo mismo ayer por motivos que no me daba la señal.
Okay, no problem, Nancy. Let's see. Vaya, Marina, ya voy a pasar la asistencia nuevamente hoy para que pueda cambiarle eso, okay, María? Okay, let's see. Okay, de nada, you're welcome. Jose Palacios, what we were studying yesterday? What were we studying yesterday?
I'm sorry, no estuve en la clase pasada.
Okay, no, Jose. Let's see, Naum, what about you, Naum? What we were studying yesterday, aparte del present?
Teacher, I'm sorry, it's my first class.
It is your first time. Okay.
I didn't be yesterday, like Jose said.
Okay, you were not here yesterday. Okay. Okay, thank you. Okay, Jorge, I know you have the answer. ¿Qué estuvimos estudiando ayer, Jorge? What were we studying yesterday?
And you said the do.
Okay, the usage of do and does, right?
And does, yes,
okay.
Right.
Como pregunta, okay. Hugo, please. Give me a question using does. Una pregunta utilizando does. A question using does.
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 Does. Do you. Does. No remember.
Okay, does, por ejemplo, does Eloisa have a long hair? Does Eloisa have long hair, guys? Does Eloisa have long hair? María, does Eloisa have a long hair? ¿Tiene Eloisa pelo largo?
I can see Eloisa right now.
Como quizás por aquí, ¿verdad? Medium hair, right?
Yes, she does.
Okay. Yes, she does. She does. Oh, la forma que queremos decir que ella no tiene. No, she doesn't. Okay, Hugo, do you have a car? Hugo, do you have a car?
Yes, I do.
Okay, yes, you do. Okay, let's see. Linda, does Hugo have a car? Does Hugo have a car?
Sorry, I acabo de conectar.
Ah, bueno, okay. Let's see, Eloisa. Let's see, Eloisa. Does Hugo have a car? Does Hugo
yes, he does.
Okay, perfect. Yes, he does. Very good. Okay, Silvana, do you have children, Silvana?
Yes, I have one.
Yes, I do. I have one. Okay.
Yes, I do.
Okay, perfect. Okay, let's see. Jorge, does Silvana have children?
Yes, she doesn't.
One yes. more time.
Sorry.
Uh-huh. Yes?
Yes. She?
Yes, yeah. Yes, she yes. does.
Okay. She does.
Yes, she does. Porque ahí le escuché que me dijo, yes, she doesn't. Y eso no, no, no está correcto, ¿ok? It is not correct. Yes, perfect. She does. Okay. Eso es lo que estuvimos estudiando yesterday. We were studying this, the simple present and there and its usage. Queríamos hacer un juego, así que les voy a compartir un enlace y se los voy a compartir por el grupo del chat. Entonces, ¿qué vamos a hacer, guys? Ustedes van a completar un juego, tienen que ordenar las palabras, no se los puedo presentar en este momento debido a los warnings que tiene Zoom, entonces no lo puedo presentar. Pero básicamente esto es lo que va a hacer. What you are going to do is to order the words. Van a ordenar las palabras que les aparezca ahí. Una vez hayan terminado, van a compartir su score en el chat. Así que me indican si pueden ver el enlace. Y nos vamos entonces a ese to that game. Okay, let me know. Me indican si podemos ver el enlace. It is in the chat. O también se los voy a compartir acá. También acá está en el chat. You can check it. Okay. So tenemos 16 students. Así que serían 16 pictures, right? Vamos a ver quién tiene the best score. El mejor puntaje. Okay, recordemos, solo es order the words. Okay, let me know if you have questions, guys. I can help you. Todos estamos en el chat, ¿verdad? Creo que la mayoría estamos ya registrados en el chat. Okay, let me know if you are not, para que le pueda compartir el enlace. Okay, Carlos, ¿estamos bien, Carlos? Are we okay, Carlos? Hello, Carlos. Hola, hola. ¿Cómo vamos con el juego? Let's see, Jairo, what about you, Jairo?
Hola, bien, gracias. Uh-huh.
Okay, do you have the link, Carlos? ¿Ya tenemos el enlace?
Yes.
Okay, very good. Let's continue.
Okay.
Okay, recordemos, when you finish, you are going to take a screenshot and share your score, right? Okay, I see Gladiador. Who is Gladiador, guys? Who is Gladiador? Okay, Gladiador.
It's me.
Manifest no, yourself.
No, okay. I'm Gladiator, yes.
Okay, you are the Gladiador. Okay, you have an 8 okay. out of... okay, you got a good score. Let's see another. Okay, parece que Linda tuvo 15 de... Okay, 15 es el puntaje. Very good. Let's see another. José Palacios, 8. Okay, very good, guys. ¿Qué palabras, qué oraciones encontramos ahí, Naum? What sentences did you find?
Okay, and the structure about simple present, you know, the mm-hmm. in third person,
mm-hmm.
and like dry to words, is that all that I remember.
Okay, very good. Thank you. Now, what about you, Jose Palacios? What is your score? What is your score, Palacios? What is your score?
8 score, and one of the sentences I can see is my mother goes to the church every mm-hmm. Sunday.
My mother goes to church every Sunday. Okay, thank you, Jose. Okay, what about you, Maria? ¿Qué palabras, qué oraciones encontramos en el juego? What sentences did we find in the game? Okay, está en mute, Maria.
No he terminado todavía, pero tengo un score de 8.
Uh-huh.
Score 8 en 30 minutos.
Seconds. Okay, very good, Maria. Thank you. Okay, Jennifer, what about you? What were some sentences you found in the game?
Works. Works.
Uh-huh.
And dry and like.
Okay.
Pregunta palabras uh-huh. o oraciones, ¿no?
Oraciones, sí, las que aparecían en el juego.
Oh, I don't remember.
Okay. Okay, thank you, Jennifer. Okay, guys, let's continue entonces. No sé si todos tenemos acceso a la plataforma de Insafor para que podamos acceder en este momento ahí. Ahí hay una pregunta, así que I need you to check that discussion I have there. Can you please check it? There is a question there. Hay una pregunta. It is in the video conference number 2, time expressions. Y hay una pregunta por ahí. Okay, can you respond that question, please? ¿Me indica si la podemos ver? The question, please. Ya tenemos el enlace para la plataforma, yes. Eloisa, ¿cómo vamos? How is everything going, Eloisa?
Perdón, es que no le entendí de qué está.
En la plataforma de Insafor, no sé si todos estamos registrados ahí. Creo que al
final. Donde dice en el curso que estamos. ¿Dónde hacemos las tareas o cuál?
Sí, donde hacen las tareas, exacto, en la plataforma de Insafor.
Okay.
Ahí hay una pregunta. There you're going to have a question.
Teacher.
¿Sí?
I have a problem the login the platform.
In the platform, okay. Sí. So, en ese caso tenemos como, existe un paso donde usted tiene que ingresar su correo, luego formatear la contraseña. Entonces, ya nos llevaría un poquito más de tiempo. Si podemos hacer eso, porque también vamos a hacer la tarea en la clase. Así que si, if you can fix that, so it's going to be good. Because at the end, we remember that that is part of your score también, ¿verdad?
Okay, I train again the login in the platform.
Okay, perfect. Okay, so let me know, please. Did you respond the questions? Jairo, what about you, Jairo? Did you respond the question? Jairo?
Hola.
Hola, Jairo. Did you respond the question?
Voy entrando ahorita.
Bye, Jairo. Sí. Estamos en esta sección, in this one, guys. Está in the video conference number 2. And you're going to answer this part, okay? The question says, what activities do secretaries do in your company, for example? In my case, for example, they check some evaluations. Entonces, ¿qué es lo que hacen las secretarias, guys? In your company, por ejemplo. Okay, so let me see your responses, guys. I need to see your responses. Let's see, Beverly, ¿cómo vamos, Beverly? Hello, Beverly. Todavía no veo las responses. No sé si tengamos algún inconveniente. Hugo, what about you, Hugo?
Teacher, no tengo una duda. Teacher.
Okay, not yet. Yes, who says that? ¿Quién dijo?
Oscar.
Oscar, yeah, tell me, Oscar.
Lo que está diciendo, ¿está donde nos metimos en el juego o está en la plataforma de inglés corporativo?
Está en la plataforma. En la plataforma.
¿Inglés corporativo?
Sí.
No, es que, pero vaya, aquí estoy yo en la plataforma. Estoy en curso, discusión, progreso y estudio. Manual, notas y videoconferencia. En videoconferencia me meto.
Entonces, en la videoconferencia, videoconference number 2, y hasta abajo hay una pregunta.
Va, ok, gracias.
Bueno. El enlace, ok. Ahorita les comparto el enlace. Ok, there you have. Pero creo que al principio les dieron a ustedes un enlace para la plataforma, cada uno creo que lo tiene. Así que, ok, si no, guys, si no lo podemos, ok, les voy a dar un minuto más para que podamos completar la pregunta.
Y hello, teacher.
Hello, yes, tell me.
Hello, hello, yes. I answered the...
The question.
I answer the question that you said, you put it in the
platform.
The platform, you know.
Okay, very good. Let yes. me check, please. Okay. Let's see. Okay, I see 4 responses. Let's see. Veamos. Okay. Okay, I got Jennifer Noemi, okay, write certificates, okay. She takes notes on the meetings, okay. Tengo el de Linda. Okay, todavía me hace falta algunos, guys. Okay, un minuto más, guys, and then we move on to the class. If you have any question, let me know. Okay, in the meantime, mientras tanto, guys, let's see. Okay, let's see. Jennifer. Hello, Jennifer.
Hello, teacher.
What do secretaries do in your company or workplace?
And write certificates and recibir pagos.
To get some payments, okay. Or they collect some payments.
Okay.
What else?
Pasar a los padres de familia a la dirección.
Are you a teacher? Are you a teacher? Yeah, yeah, really. Give me a high five.
Okay.
So congratulations for your day too, right?
Thank you.
Okay, okay. They are the ones who... Okay.
Justo no me conecté ayer, por eso estábamos bien.
Ah, me imagino. I understand that. I understand a lot.
Happy Teacher's Day.
Ah, okay, okay. That's right. That is what happens, right? At night, some days. Okay, thank you, Jennifer. So, Linda, what about you, Linda? What do secretaries do in your company or in your work place?
Yes, she takes notes of the meeting. Mm-hmm. She answers the calls of clients. Mm-hmm. She calls some proveedores, se me olvida.
Okay.
No sé.
What else?
Only that.
Only that, okay. Let's see. Jorge, what about you, Jorge? Jorge, what does secretary do?
In the day?
Yes.
In my profile is the checking the emails and the all size, but the custom.
For the customers.
And the
okay.
customer, mm-hmm. yes. And I check the I check the antivirus software in the servers.
But the secretaries, they check the virus and everything like that.
Yes.
Okay, they are wonderful.
Yes, it is only this in the secretary.
Okay, the secretary. Okay, what about you, Jose Palacios? Tell me, what do secretaries do?
In my company, checks emails every day. Planify the meeting for the bosses, and writing the documents, check the taxes, and many other responsibilities.
Activities. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Sometimes secretaries do a lot of things, right? They are multitasking, right? As teachers are. Okay. Thank you guys for participating. Okay. So I'm going to read this section and then you are going to repeat the conversation. I'm going to choose some of you for you to practice, okay? So let's read the dialogue and you tell me if there is any question. It says, what does Dominique do? Well, she is a secretary. Oh, I see. What does she do every day? Exactly. Oh, I see your point. Well, she types reports and sends emails every day. She is a hardworking woman. Absolutely. Does she arrive early? Yeah, she's the first person to arrive in the office. Questions about the vocabulary? Questions, guys, about the vocabulary? No questions?
Early.
Mm-hmm. Every day? Every day, todos los días, every day. Okay, another pregunta acerca del vocabulario. Every day, sí. Every es cada. Si solo dice every es cada. Arrive, Jorge, es llegar a un lugar. I arrive to any place, llegar a un lugar. Okay, Jorge, any other word? No? Okay. So,
no, for the moment, no.
Okay. Thank you, Jorge, for confirming. Let's see. Okay, no problem, Nancy, no problem. Vamos a leer entonces el diálogo. Okay, y voy a seleccionar who is going to be Sonia and who is going to be Pat. Who wants to read, guys? Raise your hand if you want to practice. Who wants to read? Who says me? Raise your hand, guys, if you want. Too many.
Okay, teacher, I'm going to participate.
Who Who says that?
I would like to be Sonia.
You would like to be Sonia.
No, okay. No, Hernández.
Okay, Naum, thank you. Veo que I see that. Si Carlos Bolaños wants to be Matt, right, Carlos? Okay, Carlos, usted va a ser Matt, okay? Okay. Inou is going to be Sonia. Ready? 1, 2, 3, let's go, guys.
What does Dominique do?
Mm-hmm. Well, she's a secretary.
Oh, I see. What does she do every day exactly?
Oh, I see your point. Well, she type, report, and send email every day. She is a hardworking woman.
Absolutely. Does she arrive early?
Yeah, she is the first person to arrive in the office.
Okay, thank you, Carlos. And now remember, arrive, okay? Arrive. And absolutely, absolutely. Okay, volunteers, who else wants to read, guys? Raise your hand if you want to read. Who says me? Who wants to read? Okay, Hugo, you're gonna be Sonia. Okay, thank you, Hugo. I need another guy. Who wants to participate? Volunteers? Okay, Jose. Okay, Jose. Usted va a ser. You are going to be Matt. Ready?
Ready, yeah.
Okay, let's go. 1, 2, 3.
What does Dominique do?
Well, she's a secretary.
Oh, I see. What does she do every day exactly?
Oh, I see your point. Well, she types reports and sends emails every day. She's a hardworking woman.
Absolutely. Does she arrive early?
Yeah, she is the first person to arrive in the office.
Okay, very good, guys. Excellent. Ahora voy a hacer algo. Ahora me van a decir de qué se trató la conversation. De qué se trató, what was the conversation about? Okay, tell me, please, Jairo, de qué se trató la conversación? What was the conversation about? Hello, Jairo? Okay, Jennifer, tell me, what was the conversation about?
About secretary.
Mm-hmm.
Very hard working.
Perfect.
And she arrived early.
She arrives early. Work. Okay. Excellent. Very good. Very good, Jennifer. Excellent. Okay, Oscar, ¿qué más? What else, Oscar? Hello, Oscar.
Hello.
Mm-hmm. ¿Qué más? What happens?
Estoy algo confundido, así que estoy agarrando el ritmo ahorita.
Ok, no problem, no problem. Ask whenever you want, ok? Pregunte las veces que quiera, ok? Ok, let's continue. Entonces, yes, it was about the secretary, about her daily routine and all the activities she does. Vamos a hacer este ejercicio just to refresh our minds, right, about the topic. Ok, let's see, number one, can you read it, please? Maria Emelina, please, number one. Can you read it?
Yes. Mm-hmm. She typed report.
Okay. Sería type or types?
It's types with the S in okay. The verb.
With the S in the verb. Very good. That's right. Okay. Thank you. The next one, please. Can you help me? Vanessa Odeth, ¿quién me ayuda? Vanessa, ¿cuál sería la respuesta en ese caso?
Do.
¿Vanessa? ¿Está ahí Vanessa? ¿Vanessa? Do or does.
Yes, yes.
¿Qué sería Vanessa? Sería do or does.
Does.
Ok, ¿por qué sería does, Vanessa? Why does?
One, ¿verdad?
Ok, ¿por qué does y no do?
She, tercera persona.
Because we are talking in third person singular. Very good, Vanessa. Very good. Thank you. Okay, the next one. Me ayuda, please. Walter, please.
Yes,
number three.
Does arrive does arrive early?
Okay, does she arrive early? ¿Qué sería? ¿Sería arrive or arrives?
Arrive.
Ok, sería entonces arrive. Muy bien, very good.
La S ya va en el das.
Perfect, that's it. Very good, guys. No sé si hay preguntas about the simple present. ¿Cuándo utilizamos el simple present? When do we use the simple present? Hugo, when do we use the simple present? ¿Cuándo utilizamos el simple present? Lo utilizamos para daily routines. ¿Para qué más? Para schedules también. Y más que todo, esas son las dos funciones del simple present. For routines. Ok, questions or are we okay? Questions? ¿Preguntas? No questions? Ok, let's continue, guys. Let's continue. We are good. That means to me that we are okay. Let's continue. Let's see, give me just a moment. Ok, vamos a hacer este día una listening activity. Pero antes del listening, before the listening, vamos a ver un vocabulario que lo vamos a utilizar en el listening. Tenemos irregular, sixish, night owl, nostalgic, and zombie. ¿Hay alguna palabra? Is there any new word? ¿Alguna palabra?
Six years.
Es otra forma de decir six. Six es lo mismo que six. Pero es como el six years es como algo más de la calle, podemos decir, algo más familiar. Pero eso significa six years means seis. Okay, six. That is the meaning. ¿Alguna otra? Any other? Any other word, guys? What about night owl? What is a night owl?
Owl, teacher.
Night owl. Okay, night owls son aquellas personas que trabajan y que se acuestan tarde, digamos. Esas son las night owls. People who work better at nights. People who work better at nights. Esa es a night owl. Ok, así se le llama. Ok, ¿alguna otra? Any other? No? Ok, very good. Let's see, vamos a completar, vamos a utilizar the vocabulary that we have here en las oraciones. Ok, me ayuda. The first, les voy a dar unos minutos para que podamos completar esto en sus cuadernos. Esto les va a servir para practicar, guys. Ok, eso sí les va a servir bastante. Así que, let's copy that. Se los comparto en el grupo del WhatsApp para que lo podamos ver también. Ok. Y unos minutos para que terminemos esto, guys. Ok. Tenemos irregular, sixties, night owl, nostalgic, and zombie, right? Okay, let's continue, guys. Okay, Carlos, vamos a hacer la number one mientras terminamos las cinco oraciones. Okay, Carlos, perdón. Can you read the first one, please, Carlos? Me ayuda a leer la primera. Can you read the first one?
After working 10 hours, I feel like a nightfall.
Perfect. Yes, that is the answer. It is a night owl. Are you a night owl? Are you a night owl?
Yes.
Yes, you prefer to work at nights? Or in the morning?
Work.
Mm-hmm. ¿Prefiere trabajar más en la mañana o at nights o en la noche?
No, in the morning.
In the morning, okay, that's good. Okay, thank you. Let's see, the next one is, can you help me? Okay, let's see. Let's see, Vanessa, please, Vanessa Oter. Number two, Vanessa, number two.
Come to my house around.
Mm-hmm.
Around.
¿Qué palabra? What word?
Matches. People?
De las palabras que tenemos acá, tenemos irregular, sick shoes, night owl, nostalgic, and zombie. ¿Qué palabra?
Nostalgic? No, irregular.
Come to my house around? No.
Come to my house around.
Ven a mi casa cerca de las...
Oopsies.
¿Sería?
Six.
Okay, very good. We have six sheets.
Six.
Cerca de las seis. Cerca de las seis, ¿verdad?
Okay.
Okay. Okay, for dinner. Mm-hmm. Okay, number three, let's go. Hola, Oscar. Yes. La número tres. Number three. Vive que quería ser la número tres. Okay. Oscar, go.
Estoy.
Okay, let's see.
No estoy.
Okay, he has an...
Zombie. Regular.
He has an... What is the word, guys? Hay una pista. There is a clue here. An... Usualmente... Ajá, yes, Vanessa.
Irregular.
Usualmente cuando tengamos an, la palabra que le sigue va a ser una vowel, una vocal, irregular. Very good. Okay, let's continue. Me ayuda. Can you help me? Nahum, please, Nahum. I used to be.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
I used to be a zombie, but now I go to bed. Early.
Okay. Are you a zombie? Are you a zombie now? No? No, right.
Not
you
yet.
Sleep? Not yet. Okay, that's great. Okay. The last one. Can you help me? Please. Can you help me? Let's see. Flo. No. Let's see. Hugo. The last one, please. The hardest.
I am nostalgic for my childhood.
Okay, I am nostalgic. I am nostalgic for my childhood. ¿Qué será childhood? What is childhood? What
infancia.
Is that? Infancia.
Infancia,
right.
Niñez.
Infancia, niñez. Very good. Okay, ahí están, guys. No sé si hay questions. Porque esto lo vamos a utilizar en el listening que vamos a escuchar. That we are going to listen. Okay, ready? ¿Estamos listos para el listening?
Ready.
Yes, ready. Okay, guys, perfect. Solo les comparto esto en el chat para que lo tengamos guardado, right? Okay, give me just a moment. Ya les comparto el enlace. No sé si todos tengamos el WhatsApp open, please.
Yes.
Okay, perfect.
Yes.
Okay, ya les comparto entonces el enlace. ¿Qué vamos a hacer? Vamos a escuchar el enlace de link. Lo escucha y vamos a completar el siguiente ejercicio que también se los voy a compartir por WhatsApp. Okay, guys. Que me indican si podemos ver el enlace, ¿sí?
The sentence number one, it cannot be true. After working 10 hours, I feel like a zombie.
It can be también. Yes, it has sense too. Okay. También. También se puede. Okay.
Thank
you. You're welcome. Ya tenemos el enlace, guys. Yes, ya lo abrimos el enlace. Or not yet?
Yes.
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 Okay.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay.
Teacher, sorry, ¿cuál enlace?
Ahorita se lo comparto nuevamente. Ahorita se los comparto, voy a compartir por WhatsApp también. Just a second, ahí está en WhatsApp también. Y en los ejercicios que ya se los comparto, guys, ok. Just a moment. Okay. Se los van a compartir por WhatsApp. Ok, por el momento podemos abrir el enlace, guys.
Teacher.
Yes.
In this example, I have the recording the my voice.
Oh yes, in that no. En ese tenemos que escucharlo. In this one you have to listen.
Okay. Thank you. Yes.
Indican si tienen el the exercise. You have the exercise?
Es un audio, teacher.
¿Solo el audio? Yes. ¿Podemos revisar el chat? Se los acabo de mandar.
No, es un audio. Me manda un audio.
Sí, solo es un audio.
Sí, tenemos el exercise también.
The exercise. Bueno, está bien. Vamos a escucharlo entonces y completamos el ejercicio. Voy a ver si los puedo poner acá.
Okay. Oh, good. What's your daily routine like?
Los voy a poner acá, guys. También, a ver si. Okay. Let's go. Let's answer.
So, Gareth, what's your daily routine like?
My routine is actually a little irregular. I have a different working schedule for each day of the week. But on a weekend, my son usually wakes me up about 8:30, 9 o'clock. And after that, we go downstairs and I get him some cereal, he likes at the moment, chocolate Rice Krispies. And he has a bowl of them and we watch Toy Story. He loves Buzz and Woody.
So. Every weekend the same movie.
Exactly, again and again and again. Yeah, so we watch it a lot. On weekdays though, I usually wake up at 6 a.m. I have to go to work at 8, so I commute on the bus and train, and that takes an hour and a half. It takes a long time, and then I work. I get home about 7-ish, have dinner with my wife. Usually if I come home late, she waits and she'll have dinner with me, and sometimes she waits until like 9.
Oh.
Yeah, pretty late, so it's really nice.
Are you a morning shower person or nighttime bath relax person?
So actually I think I'm a kind of night owl. I work much better in the evening, and I get more done. In the morning, I'm a little bit like a zombie. But these last years working and have kind of trained me to be an early bird. Waking up so early as I do, I've kind of adapted to it. So, but I much prefer the evening.
So you would come home from work and eat dinner, and do you then take like the bath to calm down to go to bed at night, or?
No, actually I prefer showers than baths, but yeah, I usually relax with my family and watch a movie or read a book. My son's really into Dr. Seuss books. They're classic children's books from back home, and they're great. They're even fun for me. Like that's the good thing about having kids. You kind of get reattached to your and feel kind of nostalgic about your old activities, like the yeah. things that you did when you were a child. So it's great.
Okay, guys, what ideas did you listen? What happens in the dialogue? Who can tell me? Ideas? Brainstorming ideas, guys?
Well, his daily routine is variable. Mm-hmm. On weekends, he wake up at 9 a.m.
Mm-hmm.
And she take breakfast. Mm-hmm. Cereal like mm-hmm. Choco Crispies, and she watch a movie.
Mm-hmm.
She say that she loves well she likes Toy Story.
Mm-hmm.
And on weekdays mm-hmm. he wake up at 6 a.m. She go to work at 8 a.m.
Mm-hmm.
And she arrives to his home very late, around the 7 p.m.
Mm-hmm.
She take the dinner to his wife,
mm-hmm.
and in the morning he's like a zombie.
Okay, he's like a zombie, right? And he remembers his childhood. Okay, very good. ¿Alguna otra idea, guys? ¿Alguna otra idea acerca del dialogue?
He don't like to take a shower in the morning because it's better for him in the night.
Mm-hmm. To relax for him. And I think the other guy told everything about that. Okay, very good, guys. Tenemos buen listening. Yes, that's good, guys. Okay, vamos a escucharlo nuevamente. Y ustedes me ayudan a completar las preguntas. No sé si ya las tenemos. Do you have them? Todas las preguntas. ¿O no?
No.
No yet. Vamos a responderlas entonces. Y ustedes me ayudan, ¿ok? And you help me. Tenemos unos ejercicios, ¿verdad? ¿Ok? Do you have the exercise? Everybody? ¿Sí? ¿Todos los tenemos?
Yes.
Yes, ok. Entonces, escuchémoslo nuevamente y completamos los exercises. Ok, let's go.
Gareth, what's your daily routine like?
My routine is actually a little irregular. I have a different working schedule for each day of the week. But on a weekend, my son usually wakes me up about 8:30, 9 o'clock. And after that, we go downstairs and I get him some cereal, he likes at the moment, chocolate Rice Krispies.
Mm.
And he has a bowl of them and we watch Toy Story. He loves Buzz and Woody.
So. Every weekend the same movie.
Exactly, again and again and again. Yeah, so we watch it a lot. On weekdays though, mm-hmm. I usually wake up at 6 a.m.
Mm-hmm.
I have to go to work at 8, so I commute on the bus and train, and that takes an hour and a half. It takes a long time, and then I work. I get home about 7-ish, mm-hmm. Have dinner with my wife. Usually if I come home late, she waits and she'll have dinner with me, and sometimes she waits until like 9.
Oh.
Yeah, pretty late, so it's really nice.
Are you a morning shower person or nighttime bath relax person, or?
I think I'm a kind of night owl. I work much better in the evening, and mm-hmm. I get more done. In the morning, I'm a little bit like a zombie. But these last years working and have kind of trained me to be an early bird. Waking up so early, as I do, I've kind of adapted to it. So, but I much prefer the evening.
So you would come home from work and eat dinner, and do you then take like the bath to calm down to go to bed at night, or?
No. Actually, I prefer showers than baths. But yeah, I usually relax with my family and watch a movie or read a book. My son's really into Dr. Seuss books. They're classic children's books from back home, and they're great. They're even fun for me. Like that's the good thing about having kids. You kind of get reattached to your and feel kind of nostalgic about your old activities, like the things that you did when you were a child. So it's great.
Okay, guys, let's answer. Let's see the first one, please. The first one. Who has the first one? ¿Quién tiene la primera? The first one. Who has the first one?
Letter C.
Okay, letter C. Can you write it in the chat box, guys? Si tenemos alguna respuesta different. Okay, it says he mentions what day. Okay. ¿Qué sería? What is the answer in that one?
It's a letter B.
Okay, it is letter
B.
B. Okay, what do you think, guys? Is that letter B? Is it letter B, guys? ¿Qué es lo que menciona in the dialogue?
What's the movies? Letter B.
Okay, letter B, yes. ¿Y qué más? What else? ¿Qué más? ¿Qué más? También mencionan algo. What else, guys? Did you listen?
He and his son. Crispy's son.
Okay, entonces mencionan what they eat, right?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. Very good. Okay, what about the second one? What does he say about his routine? What does he say about his routine?
Letter C, teacher.
Okay, tenemos que hablar de he gets home late. Muy bien. ¿Qué más? Do you have another question? What else do we have?
Number A.
Mm-hmm. And number, letter A. He takes public transportation. Muy bien. Okay, number three. What about number three? He says he prefers what? Evenings or mornings? What does he prefer?
Evening.
Okay, he prefers evenings. Very good. Number four. He says he usually takes what? A bath or a shower?
A shower. Letter B.
Okay, letter B. Exactly right. It is letter B. How does he feel about the books? How does he feel about the books? Childish, reattached, or nostalgic? What is the answer?
Nostalgic.
Okay. Nostalgic. Y también mencionó reattached. Okay. There you have, guys. Vamos a escucharlo nuevamente y ustedes lo van a leer. Aquí tengo el diálogo para que podamos identificar los sonidos, algunas palabras y podamos practicar, ¿ok? Let's listen again, ¿ok?
Gareth, what's your daily routine like?
My routine is actually a little irregular. I have a different working schedule for each day of the week. But on a weekend, my son usually wakes me up about 8:30.
Give me just a moment. Okay, give me just a moment, guys. Okay, give me just a moment, guys, please. Okay, give me just a moment. Parece que pasó algo acá.
Recording in progress.
Okay. Sí, que nos ayudamos más por eso. Okay. Okay, let's go, guys. Okay, let's go. Let's listen, guys, and read, okay?
Gareth, what's your daily routine like?
My routine is actually a little irregular. I have a different working schedule for each day of the week. But on a weekend, my son usually wakes me up about 8:30, 9 o'clock. And after that, we go downstairs and I get him some cereal. He likes at the moment chocolate Rice Krispies. And he has a bowl of them and we watch Toy Story. He loves Buzz and Woody.
So. Every day, every weekend, the same movie.
Exactly, again and again and again. Yeah, so we watch it a lot. On weekdays though, mm-hmm. I usually wake up at 6 a.m. I have to go to work at 8, so I commute on the bus and train, and that takes an hour and a half. It takes a long time, and then I work. I get home about 7-ish, mm-hmm. Have dinner with my wife. Usually if I come home late, she waits and she'll have dinner with me, and sometimes she waits until like 9. Oh. Yeah, pretty late, so it's really nice.
Are you a morning shower person or nighttime bath relax person?
So actually I think I'm a kind of night owl. I work much better in the evening, and I get more done. In the morning, I'm a little bit like a zombie. But these last years working and have kind of trained me to be an early bird. Waking up so early as I do, I've kind of adapted to it. So, but I much prefer the evening.
So you would come home from work and eat dinner, and do you then take like the bath to calm down to go to bed at night, or?
Actually I prefer showers than baths, but I usually relax with my family and watch a movie or read a book. My son's really into Dr. Seuss books. They're classic children's books from back home, and they're great. Even fun for me. That's the good thing about having kids. You kind of get reattached to your and feel kind of nostalgic about your old activities, like the things that you did when you were a child. So it's great.
Okay, guys, very good. Okay, questions about the vocabulary. No lo vamos a leer porque it's very long, right? So questions about the vocabulary. Any new word? Or we are okay. Yeah. Okay, let's do something, guys. Vamos a hacer algo. Necesito que nos levantemos, guys, and drink water, drink something, because I understand a esta hora tengo un poquito de sueño, así que drink water, get up, guys, go for a candy or an apple, I don't know, but stand up, guys, please. Or relax or stretch your body, guys. Guys, I understand this is late. Dice que a veces trabajamos muchas horas during the day, but ya falta poco, guys. Ya falta poco. Okay, drink water, guys, if you want. And let's continue. Okay, very good, guys. Thank you. Relax yourself, guys. Ya casi, ya casi. Okay, let's continue, guys, with the lesson. And vamos a ver este día lo que son algunas expressions que utilizamos con el simple present. Okay, let me share this. Aquí está. Okay, me ayuda a leer, please. Can you help me reading? Eloisa, please. Eloisa, what time expressions can we use for regular activities? Can you read, please?
¿Leo la indicación
Okay. Last time expressions.
Every day, week, month, year.
Mm-hmm.
Daily, weekly, monthly.
Monthly, muy bien. Estas son algunas expressions que las podemos utilizar para describir algunas actividades. Por ejemplo, I wake up early every day, por ejemplo. I wake up early every day. Every day. También tenemos a year, por ejemplo. Every year, por ejemplo, I visit my family in Canada. Okay? Por ejemplo, tenemos daily, diariamente. I daily go to the gym. Yo diariamente voy al gimnasio. I daily go to the gym. Okay? También tenemos weekly, for example. I go to church, por ejemplo, voy a la iglesia, I go to church weekly. Voy a la iglesia el fin de en la semana, semanalmente. Okay? What about monthly, al mes, mensualmente? I have to pay my bills monthly. Tengo que pagar mis cuentas mensualmente, monthly. Ok, questions, no sé si hay preguntas, alguna palabra. No questions. Ok, questions, perfect. Ahora quiero que ustedes me escriban una oración utilizando, por ejemplo, daily. ¿Qué es lo que hacemos daily? Can you write it in the chat box, please? No nos olvidemos, right? No nos olvidemos del sujeto, el verbo y la expression. Por ejemplo, daily puede ser I daily read books. Por ejemplo, I daily read books. O I read books daily. Okay, escribámosle en el chat entonces, guys. I check my email daily, okay? Linda, the good sentence, that's a good one. Okay, any other? Escribamos otra en el chat, guys. Podemos utilizar he, she, it, my mother, my family, my sister, my friends. Por ejemplo, my parents go to church weekly. Okay, you're saying I daily drive to my work. Okay, how many hours, Eloisa? ¿Cuántas horas maneja? Or just for some time? ¿Cuántas horas? How many hours, Eloisa?
Oh, 50 minutes.
Okay, not too much. Not too much. Okay, that's it. Let's see, I go to the supermarket monthly. Okay, Jorge, do you go to the supermarket, Jorge? Le pregunto porque a algunos hombres no les gusta ir al supermarket. Do you go to the supermarket?
Yes.
Yeah, okay.
I have the supermarket and the cooking in the house and cleaning the house.
Oh, that's perfect. That means you are a perfect person.
I'm not a perfect person, but trying mm-hmm. to help my family and
to help, yeah,
others activities.
Okay, very good. I daily did. Thank you, Jorge.
Okay.
It says I daily go to work. Okay, very good. Okay, estamos excellent, guys. Vamos a trabajar entonces en la siguiente actividad, in the breakout rooms, me indica si podemos ver la actividad. Esa también la podemos encontrar en sus books. Me parece que es la página 10. If you have the book there with you, si la tenemos ahí. Estamos, we are in page 13. Page 13. Ok, ¿qué vamos a hacer? Vamos a hacer, vamos a escribir 5 questions you can ask a classmate about a regular day. Por ejemplo, voy a escribir yo la mía. A daily drive, ok, perfect. Okay, sí. Tenemos que utilizar does, ¿verdad? What does she do in the morning? Por ejemplo, what does she do in the morning? Tenemos una pregunta. También podemos utilizar la yes, no question. Ok. Hagamos otra pregunta. Let's do another question. Does she wake up at 7 a.m.? Does she wake up at 7 a.m.? Yes, she does, or no, she doesn't. Ok, no sé si hay dudas, guys, de la actividad. Questions. Solo son 5 preguntas utilizando does or he, she, it. No questions. 5 preguntas serían. No? Questions, questions? No questions? Are we good, guys? Yes? Ok, entonces hagamos las preguntas y se las vamos a preguntar a nuestros compañeros. Ok, guys, let's go to work. Let's go. I'm going to form the groups and you start working. Let's go.
Llegó.
Okay, let's go, guys. Okay, let's go to the breakout rooms. Okay, very good. Let's go, Jennifer.
Okay. Uh-huh. Entonces, eso sería una mía. Do you cooking daily?
Exacto. Yes, I do. I cook every day. Diariamente, daily. I cook daily, ¿verdad?
Okay, okay. Mm-hmm. María cooking daily sería entonces.
Exacto. What activity do you do weekly?
I go to the shop weekly.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Se me borraron las
preguntas. Yo las tengo acá. Acá tengo el chat, ¿ok? Voy. Yeah. Las pondré en el chat ahorita.
Okay, okay.
¿Está en el chat?
Ahorita. What does he? Okay. Creo que, sorry, pero estoy un poco confundida en el sentido de que su pregunta fue, what do you,
what activity do you do weekly? And you say Jennifer go to the church weekly.
Okay, what activity?
Jennifer goes, okay? Okay, only okay. Jennifer, okay? Jennifer goes, thank okay.
You. Okay, you're thank welcome. You, teacher.
Okay, good job.
Okay.
Hello, how is everything going, guys?
Hello.
With the questions, hello, Linda, Walter. Okay, do you have the question?
No, I don't.
No, ahorita creo que ahí vamos, teacher.
Ahí vamos, preguntas, questions?
No.
No, digo que estamos.
Estamos bien, okay. Okay, guys, let's continue.
Yes. Okay.
And she does. She does.
Cuando utilizamos el do es porque nos referimos a nosotros. Uh-huh. Pero si por ejemplo queremos decir okay. Ella, entonces sería does she goes to the gym in the week? Ella va al gimnasio en la semana. Entonces, okay. Si por ejemplo va, entonces podríamos decir she does goes to the gym 2 times in the week o 3 times in the week. Podría ser 3 veces por semana o 1 times in the week.
What time in the week?
Okay, guys. Mm-hmm. Solo to correct something. Ahí escuché que me, por ahí escuché que me dijeron does she goes to, no sé si me dijeron, does she go to the gym? Does she go to the gym weekly? Algo así escuché. Entonces, yes. Cuando sea pregunta, recordemos que el verbo no vamos a utilizar ES, ¿ok? Does she go to the gym weekly? Luego escuché que me dijeron, she does goes. Entonces tenemos dos verbos ahí. She does goes. Entonces en este caso no podemos utilizar dos verbos. Sería she goes to the gym. Y escuché que dijo every, no sé si dijo every day o every week.
Every week.
Every week. Entonces tengamos cuidado con eso. No podemos tener dos verbos que le estemos agregando es solamente es un verbo, ¿ok?
Okay.
Okay. Okay, let's continue, guys. Let's continue. You. You're welcome. Amilcar, what happened, Amilcar?
Teacher, no fui asignado con nadie.
Con nadie. Okay, let's work aquí. Let's work here. Okay, do you have the questions?
Yes.
Okay, tell me the 5 questions, please.
Cinco.
Yes, 5 questions.
Number one, what time wake up in the week?
Okay, todavía, what time? Okay. Hijo, what time? ¿Sí?
Wake up in the week.
Wake up in the week. Week, vaya. What time do you, sería... Pero como estamos utilizando el does, sería does she wake up in the week?
Okay.
What time? Okay. Does she wake up in the week? ¿Qué hora se levanta ella? En la semana. ¿Y la respuesta?
She wakes up at 7 o'clock.
At 7 o'clock. Every, in or in the week, ¿verdad? Como estamos utilizando in the week. ¿Ok? Muy bien. Hagamos la siguiente, Milka. Let's continue.
Ok. Do you work in Sunday?
Ok. Do you work on Sundays? Ok. Do you work on Sundays?
Yes, I do.
Ok. Yes, I do. Muy bien. Very good. Okay, and la siguiente.
Sería, what does she do at work?
Okay, what does she do? Okay, esa está much better. Yes, mucho mejor esa. What does she do at work? What does she do at work? Mm-hmm, muy bien, what does she do at work?
She does a secretary.
Okay, she does a secretary? No.
No.
No sé qué quería decir en esa.
Como pregunto qué hace ella en el trabajo, ajá, quería decir que ella era una secretaria.
Ah, entonces she is a secretary. She is a secretary, okay? Okay, vamos bien entonces. Ya tenemos las otras dos, Amilcar. Do you have the next two questions?
Sí.
Okay, tell me.
What time do you take a lunch?
What time? Okay, what time does she, ¿verdad? Estamos utilizando el does. Does she?
Ah, okay.
Does she have lunch? ¿A qué hora tenemos el almuerzo? Does she have lunch? And the answer?
She takes a lunch at 12.
She takes lunch at 12 and a half, right? 12 and a half. 12 and a half, okay? Very good. No hace falta una, ¿verdad, Amica? One is missing. Tell me.
Does he work as engineer?
Okay, does he work as engineer? Engineer, okay. Does he work as an engineer? And the answer?
Yes, he does.
Yes, he does. Muy bien, Amilcar. Solo corrijamos las que hicimos al principio y las demás están bastante bien.
Okay.
Solo corregimos esas y están bastante bien. Okay, very good. Let's continue.
Okay.
Okay, let's continue and let's see. Okay, hello guys, did you finish? Hello, hello.
Yes,
finished, teacher.
Yes, okay, very good, guys. Me pueden compartir sus preguntas in the chat, please, de WhatsApp que tenemos. Can you share your questions, please, guys, in the chat? Okay, podemos tomar una captura. Ok, está bien, Jennifer, está bien.
Sí, la escribí.
Let's see.
Bueno, ¿qué?
Can you share, please, the questions?
What I do.
Ok, veamos, I see. Santos, it says, what does she do in the no, no alcanzo a leer ahí, yeah. A ver.
In the school.
Okay, well, okay, in the school. What
in the school, does
she eat in the morning? Muy bien, what does she eat in the morning? What does my brother? Veamos, where does my brother work? Quizás, ¿verdad? What does my mother?
What does my brother in his work?
Oh, what does my brother do? Me faltó el verbo. Do in his work. What does my, oh, okay. My mother read? Okay, at night. Okay, está bien. Veamos la siguiente. Okay, does she, no alcanzo a leer muy bien. Does she visit to, does she drive to work? Muy bien. What do you work? Okay. Or what do you do in your work? También, does Maria work in the morning? Muy bien. Do you have a lunch every day? What does, muy bien, very good, guys. Bien, ya las agregamos en el chat, guys. Did you send them? Bien, okay, enviémoslas todos, please, que se las voy a revisar, okay? Okay, did you send it, Linda, Eloisa, did you send them? Yes or no? Silvana, did you send it?
Yes.
Okay.
In this moment, yeah. In a WhatsApp or por aquí?
In the WhatsApp, it's much easier in WhatsApp. Aquí creo que tiene que subir el archivo y no sé qué otras cosas más tiene que hacer. Así que no, it's much easier in WhatsApp. Okay, okay, Jennifer. Okay, me indican, please. A ver cuántos tenemos en el WhatsApp. ¿Todavía hacen falta algunos? Okay, what does she do? Muy bien. Does she like to eat seafood? Muy bien, Linda. What does she do in the school on Monday? Does he go to the gym? Yes. Does she wake? Okay, Bella, it says, does she wake up, ¿verdad? Le faltó el up ahí. Do you go to the park in the evening? What do you... Okay, en esta, Linda. En Linda sería, what time, ¿verdad? What time, ¿a qué hora, verdad, Linda? What time do you arrive to work? Okay, does she drive in the morning? Muy bien. What activities? What, Emily? ¿Cómo escribimos? What, Emily? Emily, what? Okay, what? Activities. Activities también, ¿verdad? Activities. What activities? Okay, what activities do you do daily in your job? I daily attend customers and do the place. Okay, do you work in a customer service, Emily?
Yes, teacher.
I'm customer service.
I work in a drugstore.
Okay, that's good, that's good. And ahora ya sé pedir consejos cuando llama al customer service.
Con gusto.
Okay,
con gusto.
Very good, María, very good. Okay, guys. Todavía sigo esperando más respuestas. I still wait for some questions. What time do you go to the supermarket? Perfect. Jorge. And does she go to the gym weekly? Very weekly. Okay, very good, guys. Okay, let's continue with the lesson. Todavía tenemos un poquito más de tiempo. Y vamos a ver a this person, guys. Okay, me indican si podemos ver la pantalla. Tenemos más experiencias. Tenemos every day, tenemos every week, every month, every year, daily, weekly, monthly, annually. Annually. Tenemos otra expresión que la podemos utilizar, ¿verdad? Y la pregunta que usualmente usamos es how often, how often. ¿Qué tan seguido hacemos una actividad? How often do you visit your family, Oscar, por ejemplo? How often do you visit your family? How often? Mm-hmm. Oscar, how often? ¿Qué tan seguido? Por ejemplo, I visit my family every week. In my case, I visit my family every week.
Toda la semana.
Cada semana, cada semana. I visit my family every week. En su caso, how often do you visit your family?
¿Mes? ¿Cómo sería? Week, no.
Sería monthly. 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 I visit my family monthly, mensualmente. Monthly. Monthly. Okay, let's see. Nahum, how often do you go to church? For example, how often do you go to church, Nahum?
Okay, believe it or not, twice a week. Twice a week.
Oh, okay. You go to church twice a week. I believe for sure.
Okay.
I go to church twice a week. Muy bien, twice a week. Okay, Jennifer, for example, how often do you check exams, for example, Jennifer? How often do you check exams?
I check exams every month.
Every month, okay, a lot of times. Okay, that's good. Okay, let's see, Jose Palacios, tell me, how often do you practice exercise or do you go to the gym, for example? How often do you do any activity?
Exercise every day.
Every day, really? That's impressive. I cannot. I have some struggles with that. Tengo algunos problemas when I do exercise. Okay, very good, Jose. Very good.
Thank you.
Okay, what about you, Jorge? How often do you visit your family? Jorge, how often do you visit your family?
Sorry. I am visiting my family
every day. Every day, okay. You visit your family every day. Okay, that's
yes, good. Yes.
You are very close.
Yes,
okay.
Very close.
Bien.
Only one question.
Yes, tell me.
And the home office in the user for the in the user to arrive to the beach and is correct.
How often do you go to the beach?
Yes.
Okay, esa es una muy buena pregunta. La vamos a agregar acá entonces. How often? ¿Qué tan seguido? How often do you go to the beach? How often do you go to the beach? Okay, very good. Okay, what about you, Hugo? How often do you go to the beach?
Annually.
Annually, okay. I like very far, very distant, right? Okay, annually. There are so many people that go to the beach every week, right? Every week. Okay, guys. Questions? Preguntas? No questions? Vocabulary new? No? No. Okay, very good, guys. Bien, ahora sí les voy a dejar una tarea. Y quiero que ustedes me investiguen quién es la siguiente persona. Who is that person, guys? Who is that person? Who can tell me who is that person? Who that
Mr. Bean.
Okay. Parece que tiene que Mr. Bean is so famous. And what does he do? What why is so famous for?
Funny artist.
Because? Uh-huh. ¿Por qué? ¿Por qué es famoso? Why is he so famous?
Because
he is the actor for your expression.
Yes, he is an actor. Mm-hmm. ¿Qué más?
He's funny. He's funny.
He is funny, very good. ¿Qué he's más? Funny. What else? What else does he do?
His personality is very funny.
Mm-hmm.
En genial, ¿cómo se dice?
He is cool. Cool.
He's cool.
He is cool, right? He is a funny person. Funny person. He is a cool person too.
He is an excellent actor.
He is an excellent actor and funny too, right? Funny actor. Okay. ¿Qué más? What else?
Very expressive.
Okay, he is very expressive. Expressive, very good. I am not expressive a lot, but there are some people who really are. What else, Hugo? What else about Mr. Bean?
He's a tall.
He is an actor. Okay, he is an actor. Okay, very good. Parece que es bastante famoso. Parece que, yes, right. He is very famous. Entonces, ¿qué vamos a hacer? Ustedes van a ver un video acerca de las rutinas de Mr. Bean, and you are going to describe his routine, but you are going to prepare a presentation for that. Entonces, vamos a trabajar en ese tiempo que nos queda. You are going to prepare a presentation, and you are going to talk. Vamos a hablar principalmente, no lecturas, only talk, guys. Okay, no sé si hay questions.
No.
No? Okay, no, let's... Ok, entonces vamos a describir la rutina y les comparto entonces el enlace in the chat. Me indican si lo pueden ver, please. Can you tell me? Ahí es el enlace. ¿Y qué vamos a hacer? Vamos a describe the routine. Ok, ¿cuánto tiempo vamos a hablar? Un minuto, guys. Un minuto vamos a describir la rutina de Mr. Bean. No sé si hay questions, preguntas, guys, ¿no?
Entonces, ¿va a compartir el video, el enlace o cómo? Disculpe.
Sí, ya se los compartí. Me indican si lo pueden ver. Ahí está en el chat. También se lo voy a... De WhatsApp.
El video vamos a ver ahorita, Tisha.
Sí, el video. Ustedes lo van a ver porque yo aquí no lo puedo proyectar. Okay. Ahí también se los he compartido en el grupo de WhatsApp también.
Thank you.
Ok. Ahí está. Vamos a describir Mr. Bean's routine. Y vamos a hacer una presentación. Una presentación cortita, unas que 5 imágenes y las describimos. Nada más. ¿Cuánto tiempo vamos a hablar? Un minuto, ¿ok? Un minuto speaking. Okay. If you have questions, let me know. Okay, guys? Okay, guys, are you ready? Who is ready, guys? Who wants to participate? Remember, 1 minute. Yeah, who wants to try? Volunteers? 1 minute. Mm-hmm.
No wonder.
1 minute speaking.
Mr. Bean, yes.
Okay, no sé quién está hablando. Okay, Jennifer, just give me a moment. I'm just going to set my time. Let's see. Okay, ready? Who is going to speak? Jennifer, is that or Hugo? ¿Quién va a presentar? Who is going to present?
Okay.
Las damas primero.
Las damas, okay. Jennifer, is that you, Jennifer? Yes?
Okay.
Okay, 1 minute, Jennifer. Let's go.
Mr. Bean set an alarm to wake up. Also, he gets his fifth guy gets to wake up. And he puts on slippers. Also, he exercises. And also, he cares about his mate sharing. He brushes his teeth at night at 30. And I don't remember more.
Okay, good job. Very good. Un aplauso para Stephanie, guys. Un aplauso virtual. Veamos si podemos utilizar el virtual. Yes. Very good, Stephanie. 1 minute. 1 minute. Okay. Very good. Okay, Jennifer. Okay. I didn't find too many mistakes. Okay. Let's continue. Who else? Who says me? Jennifer, por favor, si me hace el favor, Jennifer, podemos completar la encuesta, las tareas que tenemos. Sería la tarea 1 y 2 de la plataforma, ¿ok?
Ok, teacher. Okay. Thank you.
You're welcome. También, ¿verdad? Los demás, mientras están participando sus compañeros, podemos completar las tareas que también es parte de su nota, ¿ok? Don't forget that. Sería la tarea 1 y 2. Ok, así que si podemos hacerlo, hagámoslo en este momento. Mientras sus compañeros participan. Vi que Hugo levantó la mano. Hugo, is that you, Hugo? O Amilcar. Who goes? Who continues? Hugo, is that you, Hugo, or Amilcar?
Yes, teacher, yes.
Okay, let's go.
Okay. So. 8 o'clock, the alarm sound. Mr. Bean. Wakes up 8:40 5. Mr. Bean, open the windows, see the sun. Mr. Bean shaves face. Mr. Bean do exercise every day. Only
that, okay, okay, very good, Hugo. Okay, solo recordemos algo, Hugo, only solo para practicar esta parte. Sería, por ejemplo, escuché que me dijo Mr. Bean wakes up 8 o'clock, algo así, creo que dijo. Entonces, siempre cuando estamos hablando del tiempo, tenemos que agregar at, ¿ok, Hugo? Mr. Bean wakes up at 8 o'clock. Okay. Ok, thank you, Hugo. Who continues? Who says me? No nos olvidemos, please, de completar las tareas 1 y 2 en de su plataforma. Ok, who continues, guys? Amilcar?
Hi, teacher.
Okay, hello. Let's go, Amilcar.
Okay. Mr. Bean wakes up a 8:45. He has a hard to sleep. When he finally to stand up to make many funny things. His routine is very simple. It's only teacher.
Okay, very good, Amilcar. Very good. Okay, solo escuché que me dijo a hard to sleep. Hard.
Yes.
Okay, a hard to sleep. Entonces,
yes.
Le entendí como que un momento difícil para dormir, ¿verdad?
Quise decirle que tenía un sueño pesado porque le costaba despertarse.
Ah. Okay, entonces en ese caso sería he has problems when sleeping.
Okay.
When sleeping.
Sueño, y si quiero decir que es sueño pesado, no existe esa expresión.
No se puede traducir así como sueño pesado, porque usted lo va a encontrar como heavy dream. Entonces, heavy se utiliza como algo de un objeto. Entonces lo tomamos como he has problems when sleeping.
Ah, okay. Como las causas.
¿Eh? Exacto. He has problems when sleeping. Okay, a veces queremos traducir como de español, así, idéntico.
Okay.
But it's good. También escuché que me dijo to makes. Siempre, ¿sí? Que tengamos el to, nunca le vamos a agregar ese al verbo. Never. To make.
Ah, okay. I don't know.
Okay, that's why we are here. Okay, Amilcar. Y también escuché que me dijo simple, ¿verdad? Simple.
Ajá, simple.
Simple.
Ajá.
Okay, simple. Es simple, okay, Amilcar.
No simple, sino simple.
Simple, okay. Sample, no, simple. Porque si decimos sample, de la forma como le dijo, el sample significa como una prueba. Una prueba.
Okay.
Por eso es importante la pronunciation, okay? Simple. He has a simple life. Okay, no sé, ¿alguien más, guys? Todavía tengo un minuto. Okay, yeah. Hello, who says me? Okay,
hello,
Walter.
Yeah.
Walter, yes, is that you, Walter? ¿O quién?
Yes, for sure.
Who says me?
Yeah.
Walter. Okay, Walter, let's go.
Okay, Mr. Bean, he left for work. Mr. Bean sleep much. The routine of Mr. Bean. Mr. Bean wakes up them at night. Mr. Bean eats rice in the morning. Mr. Bean took her teddy bear. Mr. Bean leaves his house at night. Only.
Okay. Bien, Mr. Bean took her. Okay. Escuché esta oración. Mr. Bean took her teddy bear, right? No sé si estoy correcta. Mr. Bean took her teddy bear. ¿Sí?
T-O-C-K.
T-O-C-K. Talk.
No, la O es U.
Took, ¿así?
Ah, took, yes.
Ok, took no es un verbo, creo que sería takes, ¿verdad? Takes, toma, ¿verdad? Toma o lleva. En este caso, como estamos hablando de él, vamos a utilizar his, ¿ok? Here es solo para el sexo femenino, ¿ok?
Okay.
His. Mr. Bean takes his teddy bear. Okay. Okay.
El día le quise poner a ropa. Entonces eso me tradujo.
Ah, okay.
Sí.
Ya
a ropa su oso, su osito teddy.
Okay. Entonces vamos a ver mañana eso porque el tiempo se me ha ido. Y le decir esa palabra también que está interesting. Okay, guys. Solo paso asistencia y me quedaría entonces. El día de mañana vamos a seguir siempre. Todos vamos a participar. Everybody's going to participate, guys. Y solo para asistencia, guys, si no nos olvidemos de completar la tarea, ¿ok? Si lo podemos hacer en tiempo, hagámoslo mientras paso lista para que no se nos vaya a acumular eso, ¿ok? Solo para confirmar, ¿Amílcar está ahí? ¿Amílcar?
Yes, teacher.
Ok.
Here.
Okay, very good. Ok, did you finish the task? ¿Terminamos las tareas?
En eso estoy, teacher. Ah,
perfecto. Nos podemos retirar ya, Amílcar. Ángela Alejandra, you're welcome. Ángela Alejandra está ahí, Ángela. Ángela, ¿no está? Bien, Carlos Ademir está, Carlos Ademir. No, ok. ¿Sí? Ok. ¿Está Daily Lizette? ¿Daily Lizette? ¿Está Daily? ¿Daily no está? ¿Hugo Alexander? ¿Hugo Alexander?
Present, teacher.
Okay.
Present.
Thank you, Hugo. Veamos, José Naum. ¿Está José Naum?
Hello, teacher.
Ok. ¿Está, veamos, Mabel Hernández? ¿Mabel Hernández? ¿Mabel? ¿No está Mabel? María Emelina, María Emelina. Ok. María Emelina, ya le dije, ¿verdad? María Emelina. Margot, ¿está ahí Margot? Margot, ¿no está? ¿No está Margot? Bueno, está Vanessa Odeth, Vanessa Odeth. ¿No está Vanessa?
Yes, teacher.
Está bien. Y tengo a Walter. Walter, sí, ¿verdad? Y Jairo Vladimir. ¿Está Jairo Vladimir? ¿Jairo Vladimir? ¿No? ¿Y Linda Vanessa? ¿Linda?
Present.
Ok. Thank you, Linda. Bien, no nos olvidemos de completar las encuestas.
Falté yo.
Pero, ¿quién fue su apellido?
¿Su apellido? Esquivel Quiñones.
Esquivel Quiñones.
Oscar Armando.
Ah, perdón, Oscar. Ah, sí, aquí está Oscar. Sí, no lo llamé porque ya lo había llamado antes. Por eso no lo había llamado.
Sure.
Ajá. Bueno. Ok, no nos olvidemos la encuesta y mañana seguimos con las presentaciones. Yes, dígame.
Ah,
era porque ya lo había escrito, por eso. Yo lo había pasado.
Había chequeado.
Sí, sí, sí.
Es que habemos dos Hugos, por cierto, en la clase.
Ah, vale, permítame, solo reviso eso. Silvana se queda, por favor, no se le vaya a olvidar. Y Hugo, ¿verdad? Los dos Hugos que tenemos. Hugo. Sí, tengo a Hugo Ernesto y Hugo Alexander. Ayala.
Ajá, correcto.
Ah, vale, entonces sí, aquí leo. Ya tiene entonces, Hugo.
Thank you, teacher.
Ok, you're welcome, thank you. Ok, me quedo con, see you ladies, see you boys, me quedo entonces con Silvana, ¿está ahí Silvana?
Good night.
Good night. Have a nice day, you guys. Tomorrow, see you, Silvana. Okay.
Good night.
Good night, boys. Okay, Silvana, me quedo con usted.
Good night.
Good night, guys. Take care.
Thank you. Take care, you too.
Thank you so much. Bien. Silvana, no sé si tengamos dudas de algún tema.
Sí. Estaba haciendo la tarea número 2 y quiero saber cuál es la diferencia de each week con weekly.
Vale, permítame. La palabra sería, la palabra es
each de otros, creo, o
each
de cada.
Each week y tenemos every y la otra
y weekly.
Y weekly. Bien, la diferencia entre, lo podemos llamar como que uno es un adverbio, que usualmente va, el weekly va al final. Weekly significa, weekly significa semanalmente. Weekly. Por ejemplo, yo trabajo semanalmente 40 horas. I work 40 hours weekly. Trabajo semanalmente 40 horas. En cambio, each week, nos referimos a cada semana. Por ejemplo, each week I go to church. Por ejemplo, I go to church each week. Entonces, básicamente esa sería la diferencia. Una significa semanalmente y la otra cada semana, right?
Pero eso no tiene como una conjugación de cómo se llama, de verbo o de sujeto.
Como ahí, simplemente... Eso no modifica, por ejemplo, los verbos que hemos estado viendo con he, she, it, we, you, they. Por ejemplo, que tengamos she, ¿verdad? En el caso de she. She works 40 hours weekly. No cambiaría nada. Nada de lo que es la oración. Uh-huh. No sé si hay más questions.
No
questions. Bien, entonces vamos a practicar el tense que estamos viendo, que sería el simple present. Yo le voy a dar unos ejercicios para que puedan practicarlos, ¿ok?
Ok.
Solo me da un momentito que ya se los comparto. Aquí están. Me indica si los puede ver. ¿Sí?
Sí.
Entonces lo único que vamos a hacer es to write the verb in the correct form. Por ejemplo, I usually go to school. Muy bien. They, ¿cómo quedaría el verbo? They?
They visit.
They visit. Y si la quiero hacer en negativa, ¿cómo me quedaría? They.
They don't visit. No, they...
Va bien. Ya la tenía. You got it. Okay.
They don't visit us often.
Excellent. There you have. Vamos con you play. ¿Cómo sería el verbo aquí? You play basketball.
Play basketball once a week.
Once a week. En negativa, ¿cómo podemos hacer esta? En negativa.
You don't play basketball once a week.
Okay. ¿Y si le quieren pregunta?
Do you play basketball once a week?
Excellent, Silvana. Very good. What about Tom? Y el verbo es work.
Tom works every day.
Como pregunta, as a question, Silvana.
Does Tom work every day?
Perfect, Silvana. Vamos con la number 5. He always
the love funny story. No, he always tells tells us funny story.
Muy bien. He always tells us funny stories. Y si la quiero en negativa.
He doesn't always tells of funny story.
Ahí, otra vez, one more time, please. He doesn't always
tells us funny story.
One more time, Miss Silvana, one more time. Escucho una S por ahí que se me está escapando.
He doesn't always tell us funny story.
Much better, excellent, that's good. Sigamos, number six.
She never helps
me with that. Y como negativa, so negative.
She never
helps me with that. Okay. Marta and Kevin. What about Marta and Kevin?
Marta and Kevin swim twice a week.
¿Y como negativa, as a negative?
Marta and Kevin, Tom, swim twice a week.
Ok, solo recordemos, Silvana, que no es, es swim, sino que es el sonido de la S, swim, ¿ok?
Swim.
Swim, solo swim. Sin el, porque a veces le agregamos la E, ¿verdad? Es swim, no. Solo el sonido de la S, swim.
Swim, ok. Swim,
perfecto. Ok, Silvana, vamos a dejarlo hasta acá. No sé si tiene más cosas, Silvana. Si no, I let you go and sleep a lot.
O sea que cuando... Cuando utilizamos negativo, ya no le agregamos la S a lo que son.
Al verbo. Ah, okay. Exacto. Siempre que tengamos he, she, and it, Silvana. He, she, and it. Uh-huh. Solo para eso se aplica, ¿ok?
Ok.
Ok. Siempre se aprende algo, ¿verdad? A veces necesitamos como refresh, right?
Ok.
Ok, that's good, Silvana. Thank you so much. No sé si hay más dudas, si no, nos vemos tomorrow. Ok, thank you. Have a good night.
Have a good night. Bye, teacher.
Bye-bye, Silvana. Take care.
Yes.